There's my piano. I should join with Christine in the game of name that tune. Yes, I should. I should join with her in the game of name that tune. My goodness, it's dark out here tonight. Yes, it is. It's dark. Look, there's the other room. There's that room. And there's the other room. And this is the patio. Here we are in the twilight. I should turn on the swimming pool light. Except I might fall down and get down to the switch. So I'll just let it go at that and say, here I am between two bright lights, not knowing where to put my damn face to get a good picture. I thought I had it worked out, and it turned out they both blinded the camera. That'll teach you something about making a film, Danny. You got to get your light sources right. Yes, you do. Yes, you do. Look at that. That's no good at all. The only one that's any good is that one. That angle's pretty good because there's light coming out of the house. And then there's the mountain behind me, the suburban mountain of San Diego. Yep. That's okay then. We'll just let it go as it is. Because we never know where we're going to go next, do we? Whether we're going to zoom in on that. Ooh, I can't even see it. It's too dark. Yep. So that's enough. The light's not good. I have to start over. Yeah, look at that. My house is a mess. Just an utter mess. And I'm out here behind the camera in the twilight. Yeah. There's still too much light behind me, really, to get a good shot of me. But I'm here enjoying one of the last cool evenings of spring. Yep. It's a very beautiful night. I'm sitting outside with the light from one room shining into another room and then shining out past the piano to me. The piano makes me think that I should play the game that Christine has opened us up to. Name that tune. Isn't that fun? Isn't that fun how that works? Yes, it is. Well, there are a few days to go before we start getting burned up by the heat, although I understand up in the northwest, Portland and Seattle, they're starting to get, and into Canada, Victoria, Vancouver. They're going to get a heat situation. That's what I hear. But I don't know. I don't know. We'll just have to wait and see. You never know what the weather will be. Everybody talks about it, but then it surprises us. Everything's different now, though, isn't it? When I was a kid, we pretty much knew what the weather would be for years to come. The scientists always warned us it could change, it could change. It's changed in the past. It changed. There's been change in the past. And they told us about the ice that covered half the planet. And it wasn't until years later we found out that there was a time, even long, long ago, when the whole world was covered with ice. It's been a long time working out the balances here. And we seem to be contributing to it. with a supply of carbon dioxide and oxygen that are essential atmospheric elements for plants and animals. Look, it even sounds like I know what I'm talking about. I lived here when I went to school and we saw movies about the ice ages. I lived right here when I was a kid. And all these many years later, the house is different. There's fans in the house. We didn't have fans on our ceiling lamps. Do now, of course. It's climate change. You gotta have fans. Nah, there's something else going on here. We didn't have ceiling fans back in those days. We had lamps in the middle of the dining room. There's one. I'm looking right in at the lamp. It's out now. And it's three lamps, and above the three lamps are four blades of a fan. Now, I cannot remember the ceiling lamp we had, but I believe it was lit by the switch that's over there on the wall, and it had six or seven lights on it. It was sort of like an electric, well, I don't want to call it a chandelier because it wasn't big and fancy. You think the chandelier has to be something like on the Phantom of the Opera. You have to have a chandelier that is so heavy it could crash down on your table and kill someone who'd been invited over for a intervention. I don't think we ever had an intervention here. Mine might be the first if my drinking gets the worst of me. There's a little off-the-cuff admission to you. I've had three drinks today. No, I've had two. I'm working on my third one. And I had a wonderful nap. From about 3 until 5, I slept and slept and slept. So I'm feeling quite not tired, thank you. Fed the dog. Make sure she can't come out, go in and come out for a few hours. Now I've had the door standing open. The weather's good enough to let the door stand open and let the air flow in and out. And that's the beauty of living in California. You can live indoors and outdoors right through the door. Now, sometimes you need to have a screen because now and then you get bugs. But you hear all that noise in the background, the crickets and those frogs. And we got lots of birds, too. So the bugs pretty much get eaten around here by the animal life. It's very, I suppose the reptiles eat them too, the little lizards that I see running everywhere. Well, there's not that much of a bug problem. We never have clouds of mosquitoes that descend on you and suck your blood. Although in the summer we do have them. They come around one or two at night, buzzing and snarling. That's when you have to have the screens. Try to help somewhat keep them out of the house. But I'm getting off the subject here. I wanted to talk about how beautiful this night is. While I look at the evening going down behind me, reflecting through the viewplate of my camera here. Back up a little bit. You can see outside. And you can see how there's trees all around this place. And the roof of the patio, of course, makes its own blockage. But out here is pretty much the biggest piece of open sky we have, which is to the east. And stretching sort of from southwest to northeast. We have a piece of open sky over there. That's about the only place you can see a big piece of sky, and it's only a few 30 or 40 degrees. I'm really shut off from the stars down in this little canyon, but they come out now and then and I can see them, and the moon shines in the bedroom window, and so about half the month, if it's not cloudy, for 2 or 3 weeks I can see the moon at night now and then, because I get up to go to the toilet, you know, and sometimes the moon will be shining in the windows. It's getting very old now. It's almost going to be new again. We're in the last quarter. We're coming into the last week of the moon. And it will disappear into the morning. In the morning, before sunrise, you can see it now, and if it's not cloudy. But it's cloudy here. We have our night and morning low clouds. I talked about that in my last video, complaining about our secret of clouds that block the sun in California, our May gray and our June gloom. Well, there's some openness in the sky tonight, and I saw the sun even towards the end of the last hour before sunset. I saw the sun shining on the hill across the street, up on one of those big houses that Frank said, now that the trees have been trimmed, that big house up on the hill, see me skinny dipping, which is quite apropos, because, as we know, water gets warmer in the summer. And I ain't got no heater on this cement pond out here. This pool, it's in dark now. One night I'm going to turn on the light before I make a video out here. That'll light us all up. Damn. So, as I was saying, the pool will get warm and I'll be swimming. But this year, I have swimming trunks. I have pants that I can wear in the pool, so I won't be afraid of the neighbors spying on the big old fat man skinny dipping. No, not this year. Not this time. Yes. And with that, I think I will say goodnight, my friends. God bless you.